Saraju Mohanty.
And I am Elias Koyanos, and the project we're working on is a low power design methodology for new generation microchips.
It will be used to create chips that will consume very minimal power, which are used in all the portable applications like mobile phones, digital cameras, and laptops, and so on. We have been working on this research for maybe last 10 years, and Dr. Koyanos has been working on maybe last 20 years in this area. Actually, he worked in industry, and now in academia. I've been working in academia, so we have been doing research actually quite a bit on this area. There is a strong potential actually. Like the way everybody thinks, they think in terms of how to generate more energy to fill the need, but we are talking about a different idea where we want to say how to reduce our consumption. Okay, so if we reduce our consumption, our energy needs will be less. Okay, so that is a very good alternative compared to being dependent on those fossil fuels and so on.
Everything in our modern life revolves around being mobile. So the key to all these new technological developments is to be able to provide us with equipment, just like the camera you're using to record this conversation now, that is completely mobile. Just a few years ago, you would need a very large camera with a very large powerful battery and probably another source of power to record this conversation. Now you can do it with a handheld gadget that consumes less power than probably a digital watch. So this is the kind of application that we're looking
at. The secret is to design the circuits which are much smaller. Okay, and using smaller transistors with less number of transistors, and each one consuming as less power as possible. So that is the basic. We can claim around 60-70%. If your device consumes less power, that means the what they call as the carbon footprint or something like that, right? So you'll have a very small carbon footprint. That is one. And this thing. How much how frequently you charge your device with the regular power supply, that reduces, which has a lot of impact on the fossil fuel and other things. So you do not use that many natural resources that you will be using currently.
We're also talking about a different way of thinking about designing the chips, different approach in the design process of the chips. So this methodology can affect all kinds of possible portable applications. So the impact can be very wide, not only on a very specific segment of the market, but the entire mobile market. It's an entire mindset, an entire way of thinking about how to make something that will perform its functions well using the minimal amount of power that it can. Because in the past, everybody was saying performance, performance, performance. And we have very powerful computers now, but they consume a lot of power. So what we want is, during our design methodology, to come up with a trade-off between power consumption and performance at the same time. So that's the key there. You know, we want to maintain the performance while keeping the carbon footprint, the energy consumption to a minimum.
People like to know that I have a 3 gigahertz machine, I have a 2 gigahertz, those kind of gigahertz. People like, when you go to a retailer to buy a computer, you like to see those numbers. 3 gigahertz, 4 gigahertz, those kind of numbers. You don't see what is the milliwatt or watt power consumption as a common user. So industry, semiconductor industry made things that they can sell. So that is how the thing is. Elias, you want to add?
Yeah, in addition, it's a fundamental fact of physical law that the higher performance you get, you need to expend more power. That's everybody can understand that. And in the past, power was thought to be abundant and cheap. We didn't care about polluting the environment. We could put some more power plants, generate all the power we want. Suddenly, the last few years, we realized that, wait a minute, power is not cheap. It's actually very expensive. And generating this power has tremendous impact on the environment. We can't just go on assuming that we're going to have infinite amounts of power in our disposal. Therefore, we have to make the devices that perform so well today, using a lot of power, perform as well or even better, but using a lot less power. Otherwise, we're going to have a serious problem.
Don't look for alternatives. Let us see how we can mix matter things.